talking about my people, we're talking about Nigerian leaders have already come out, like example Pat Utomi, you know, the prolific leader out of Nigeria, have already come out and said Nigerians should emulate and follow the footstep of Ghana in times of bringing back diasporas. So the Nigerian leaders now are saying we need diasporas too in Nigeria. Are we ready to give them citizenship and to do naming ceremony for them? What do you think about this?
Yes, we need them.
In Nigeria?
Yes, we do. Pat Utomi is a professor of political economy and management. So if he says something like this, I tend to believe in. Ghana is doing it.
And they are making a lot of
And it's working for Ghana.
People.
So why not
Nigeria? A lot of infrastructure, developmental growth in Ghana. A lot of hotels, you know, hospitals, you know, have been built by the diasporans, mainly, mostly people coming from America and the United Kingdom. Enormous hotels and hospitals, schools too. You see, Michael Blackson built free schools in Ghana. You can check this out on this platform. We've already talked about it.
Yes.
Free schools. And you know, Jay-Z might start a record label in Ghana. Charlamagne Tha God can start a radio station in Ghana, a very big one. And the number one comedian in the whole world, Dave Chappelle, they all invested in Ghana. So this is the good look for Nigeria too. Like, we need diasporas.
Yes, we do. We do. And about, I think about 3-4 years ago, one of the presidential candidates under the platform of AAC, Omoyele Sowore, who had lived in the United States for about 20 years, said the money Nigerians living abroad, sending home to their families, is more than the health Western world give to Nigeria.
Yeah, for sure.
For sure. So that is, that
because
means,
if you think about our population,
we have the population, and our population controls huge sum of money.
Yeah.
Now, if these people can come home, imagine how much they will put into the economy of Nigeria.
That would be a lot of money. Like, you see, Floyd Mayweather, that want to come and start, you know, the boxing business in Nigeria.
That is a plan of $50 million from one person.
And Lil Wayne state is in Nigeria too.
Now, majority of African Americans, majority of them, I believe, will be from Nigeria.
Oh, for sure.
Now, let us assume that even 10% of them are ready to return home, to do one kind of business or the other. That is a volume of dollars. Population of African Americans.
10% of the population of African America in Nigeria.
In Nigeria.
That would be a lot of turn up for Nigerians. You know, that would be a lot of money. Yeah.
That's a lot of expansion. Even Nigerians that are not African Americans, there are a lot of them doing well in America, in Canada, in UK. If those people can even come home and invest and encourage people, share knowledge, introduce their expertise to Nigerian economy.
Because they are professionals.
They are professionals.
International professionals.
International, world-rated professionals.
They have more knowledge than the people back home.
Let's take sports, for instance. Israel Adesanya is a Nigerian. He's doing well.
Yeah.
AJ. Anthony Joshua.
He's doing well.
The first one is MMA.
Yeah,
winner.
But he lives in Switzerland, you know, but he's a diasporan. He's a Nigerian diasporan.
AJ, Anthony Joshua, heavyweight boxer.
But he lives in UK.
He lives in
but
UK.
He's a Nigerian diasporan.
Yeah. Usman.
Yeah.
MMA, UFC fighter.
Yeah, Usman.
A champion.
He lives in the United States of America, in Florida, but he's a Nigerian.
He's a Nigerian.
And he's a diasporan, yeah.
We have many
a
of
lot
them.
Of them.
Musician, Shade Adu, is a Nigerian.
Yeah.
We have
even
many.
Lil Wayne says he's a Nigerian.
So,
Big Sean says
these
he's a
are the people we already know. We have Nigerian youth. They are not African American. They are Nigerian. They are living abroad. These are rich people.
Yeah.
Who can clean up the mess of youth crime if they come?
And even help the, you know, the unemployment issue in Africa.
Of course. These are people that can invest millions of dollars in Nigeria. The only thing is for the government to make the environment good for them.
Suitable for them to
stay.
Suitable
for them.
And to save and back and back them up in anything they do in terms of business, support in terms of development.
If it is possible, they'll
be able to develop more and invest
waivers.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, to make them feel comfortable in that country. Yeah, for sure.
These are the things that we encourage people to come. Pat Utobi is right. At least it is working in Ghana. It can work in Nigeria. Let us encourage these people to come and invest back home. Even if they don't want to live here, they can invest on the promises that government will be on their side.
Able to supervise them and support them and help them out in everything they do. So my people, this is a good look. Pat Utomi, you know, a prolific, you know, philosopher from Nigeria, have already come out and stapled this, like, Nigerian too need the diaspora and Nigerian should emulate what Ghana have already done in their own country. So my people, this is what we're talking about on Africa Unity TV. It's all about development of African children, development between Ghana, Nigeria, you know, togetherness, oneness, and everything that the African children already do to safeguard themselves and present their story to the world the right way, the rightful way it should be. So my people, be going to the next one.